Hi guys, Matt Lemke here again, and we're at the Modiphius Entertainment booth, Gen Con 2018, and we're going to play Fallout 4. Well, an abbreviated version of Fallout 4. And this is TJ. He's going to tell us about all things Fallout that he knows.
All the things I know. Which is a couple. One or two.
So tell us about the game.
So we're going to be running a demo here of the Fallout Wasteland Warfare game. It's from Modiphius Entertainment. So we're basically going to be running a quick scenario here where you've got your super mutants on this side and you've got your settlers on this side. They're going to be trying to hack some terminals here that we have strategically placed to get into a vault, get some goodies. And the super mutants are going to be trying to stop them because that's what they do. So they're going to be trying to find out what's underneath these two searchables here. To find an electrical outlet to smash it so they can't open the door. So we're going to be going back and forth and seeing what happens.
All right, we're going to switch.
Would my assistant hold this, please?
What?
Yes, it's Vanna White.
No, it's not.
Make me proud.
I'll try.
You must be the social media guy.
Over here, yes. I haven't over here yet.
I mean, they're the same effects.
Yeah,
so
they are the same
effects.
Yeah. I didn't know if they were the same cards over here.
Yeah, we
popped out some creatures yesterday, which was fun. Some rad roaches came out.
Yeah, it's different looks.
Yeah.
White.
Yeah.
Yep, twist it, please. A little more. A little back. Right there. Awesome sauce. We can go.
All right, so the way this game starts out is the team who has the least amount of models goes first. Since we both have four, we're going to just roll off here. Whoever gets the highest amount on the dice will go first, so you can roll that one there. All right. So you got a one. So I got a three. So I have the option to go first. I don't have to go first if I don't want to, but I might. So the first thing you want to do before you move, before you do anything, is you want to take an activation token. Which is a nice blue in here. You see the gray on the back. The blue token will go next to one of my super mutants that I want to activate first. It's probably going to be my brute here because he's awesome. So I'm going to put an activation token next to him. I don't have to use that. He's got two actions to move if he wants. But what I can do is I can pass. If I pass, that allows my opponent to activate one of his models. And he can either choose to move it or not. Same as me. Whether he moves one or not, he will eventually come back to me. I will get to activate another super mutant, and then I can move both of them if I want because I had not used my actions from the last super mutant. So I'm going to go ahead and activate my brute, and I'm going to pass to my opponent here, the settlers, and see what he wants to do.
Well, I guess I'm going to activate somebody.
You are going to activate someone.
This guy.
Activate a settler. So with your cards here, you got your soul survivor, which is here. You've got two settlers, which are here and here. And then you've got trusty old Dogmeat there, right in the middle. Yeah, so you've got two settlers. So your assault rifle and your baseball bat will go with your settlers here. Your soul survivor gets the, what do you got here? You got the hunting rifle. Yep, that'll go there. All right, and then Dogmeat gets the dog bite token here because that is a dog only.
I would hope.
you hope. We hope. All right, so since you've activated your settler there, you can either choose to activate that settler and use two moves, or you can pass back to me and see what I'm going to do.
I will pass back to you.
All right, perfect. That's exactly what I was hoping you were going to do.
I'm screwed.
Because I'm going to activate my mutant hound over here. So to get a little better look here, we're gonna take some of this terrain apart, this beautifully painted terrain we have here. So you guys can see across the map.
But they didn't make it.
So I've got my dog right here. So I'm actually going to choose to activate both of my guys here. So I'm going to move my dog here first. So as you see on the card here. in the top left-hand corner is your movement. The first rectangle, the first square is how far you can move in a normal move. The second is a charge. So for a charge, you have to finish in base contact when you're charging. And you also get a little bonus for it. Super mutants get a bonus for charging. They get a lot of fun stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and move my dog and try to get into the charge range so I can start start messing some stuff up here.
My dog's going to eat your dog.
It's a strong possibility. So the great thing about this Super Mutant dog is that he's got the leap ability. So you'll see some special abilities here at the bottom of your cards if they have them or not. So he can move straight through terrain. It doesn't matter. He can do his thing. He can jump over stuff. So what we're going to do here is you move front to back. So there's no trying to measure it to the very end. It's just front to back, plain and simple. And then my charge range here pretty much puts me in range of just about anybody here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to charge in to this settler right here that's active. All right, which I'm okay with, because I know my Super Mutant Hound is much stronger. And so because you get a bonus on your charge and I don't get to use it because I'm out of actions, I've used both my actions, one movement, one charge, I'm going to put this little token here to remind myself that when I do get my attack, he gets that bonus because he was the one who charged it. So that tells me I get to roll one extra damage because you always get a bonus damage dice when you're rolling on the charge, which would be your black one here. So all your dice are separated into damage dice, which are your black ones. They are most likely to cause damage. They can do some other things. Your accuracy die, which are your green ones. So as you can see, they have a lot of pluses and minuses on there to make your accuracy a little bit better. These are your armor penetration die, which are the yellow ones, which have mainly armor penetration rolls on them. And then you have your activation die, which is the one that you're going to roll pretty much every time. Actually, every time. I've never been in a scenario where you don't roll. And then you've got your armor die here, which basically decides if you're going to stop any armor, if you're going to take all the damage. All right, so that's a little quick run through the die. So that is, since I activated him and moved him, I'm going to take the little token and I'm going to flip it over saying that he's moved and he cannot move until our next round. So I'm going to take my brute over here, who's all hyped up and ready to move, ready to do some stuff, and he's going to start moving forward. So he's going to move forward to right here, front to back. All right, and then I've got a couple options. I can either shoot his laser rifle, I can move him again. He's not very good at shooting, but, you know, just for the funsies, let's see what happens when he shoots his laser rifle. So he's going to be in the single range. So when you're measuring for distance on long-range weapons, you've got two different colors here. So let's take the bolt-action pipe rifle, for instance. You've got a green is your short range, which would be this one. And then you have a blue, which is the long range. So short range would be measured with one stick. Long range would be measured with both of them.
That's the table.
That is the table. Sometimes the table is a little bit bigger. The one over there we have is a little bit bigger. But as you can see, as you go from short range to long range, it changes what you can do, what kind of dice you're rolling, how much damage you can do. It kind of changes the game a little bit. So you generally want to be a little bit closer when you're shooting. So one stick here in the long range is pretty great. So I'm gonna, in the short range, so I'm going to go ahead and try to do that and see what happens. So I'm going to get my activation die here, my action die. I'm going to get a black and a blue because on your card it tells you what you're going to roll. So I'm going to go ahead and roll these three together and see what happens. All right, so I got the quick action cog, which is good. So it gives me a quick action, which he doesn't really have much he can do, but he might be able to search, which he can, which that's good. So I'll explain that here in a second. So he's got that quick action cog, which counts as a one, so it's an automatic hit. I got the star on the special die, which on some of these you can see here, like on the bottom of the laser rifle, they have a couple of different icons here. If what I rolled on the blue dice matched one of these icons here on the bottom, I can spring a special ability. So So in the case of the laser rifle, you can set them on fire, you can do an armor penetration hit, any of those things. So unfortunately, my brute doesn't have anything that helps there, and then a blank on my damage die means you got nothing, unfortunately. But I did hit, which is fantastic, so that's going to trigger something on your side. So you're going to look at your settler. So you're going to find your settler, and you're going to find the red box at the bottom.
Okay.
With the helmets, right?
Yep.
So that will tell you what your different armor defenses are, all right? So you're one down the board except for radiation, which you just take radiation right in the face if you get radiated, all right? But since I'm doing energy damage for my laser rifle, I'm sending two at you. So you're going to pick up this dice, and you're going to try to find a one on that dice. So you want to match what you have down here or lower. So since you have one, there is nothing lower. So you can only stop one of the two damage I'm sending your way.
That's only if I roll a one.
That's only if you roll a one. You rolled a three, so you did not, so all that damage comes through. So you pick up two damage counters and you put them right on top of your settler.
Those are the little star ones.
Those are the little star ones, yep. So we've got those, we have them in fives, twos, and ones. Put that right on your settler there. Yeah, so since you've only got one of those settler cards and you've got two settlers, just keep them separate in case there's damage done to the other one. So you got that taken care of. He's done his shooting. We created some damage. Now, since I got that quick action, so what you can do is, I don't know if I have any quick action tokens. I don't think I do. But we do have quick action tokens. So I'll go ahead and put this one down here just to take place of the quick action token. So quick actions are found at the bottom of your card here. They're different things you can do. You can search. You can kind of hunker down and get ready for an attack. You can, as you see with the Soul Survivor, it has the dog handler special, so you can pass a quick action on to Dogmeat, which can be very helpful because that can give Dogmeat, as you can see, an extra movement down here. Dogmeat can search for things and find them and bring them back to you just like in the game. So that's a really good companionship right there, which is another kind of strategy that kind of helps you do some fun things in the game. So since my brute here got a quick action, as you can see here in the bottom, you can see the quick action. This is your search marker right here, and it coincides with the color of the length and the distance that I can search. So I can search in a green. So this search marker here, which is what I'm trying to find for our little scenario here, is well within that green. So I can search that and flip it over, and it is one, which is a designation marker, which is not what I'm looking for. So I know that I've got to get to this other one because I searched that. So I've got to get in with base contact with this other one to figure out what it is and search for it and keep these dirty settlers from getting into my vault here. All right, so that ends my turn because I've moved both of my guys, both of their actions. So now it goes back to my opponent here.
And now I sign an action.
So now you do another action. You designate another movement.
I'm going with Dogmeat.
All right, going with Dogmeat. All right, so now you can either pass back to me or you can choose to activate both of your teammates.
I'll activate them both.
All right. So you have to finish both movements of one before you go on to the other. So figure out which one you want to use first.
Well, Dogmeat is going to attack the dog.
All right. So if you want to run, charge in with Dogmeat, so you're going to get some bonuses here, which is going to be a lot of fun. So you got the blue, which is Dogmeat's charge there, the second one. So he's clearly within that. So you're going to charge Dogmeat in here in a base contact, all right? So he's good to go. So yeah, go ahead and flip that over. So that's one movement. So now you have two, all right? So I'm assuming you want to attack. So you're going to get the regular die, and then you're going to look at Dogmeat's attack here. So you get a yellow, a green,
and a blue,
all right? And since he is charging in, you get another one of these, right? And because you're outnumbering him, get to roll another one of these.
That might hurt that guy.
So there's a lot going on there. So you're gonna roll those, and what you're looking for is Dogmeat's attack here is the knife here. So you're gonna find the corresponding symbol. And so you're looking at Dogmeat's agility. So Dogmeat's agility is 8. So you're gonna be looking for an 8 or lower on that white die, and that's gonna tell you if you make a hit or not. Game or
roll them all at the same time?
All at the same time. Alright, so this is fantastic. So you got a crit, which is awesome. you got two extra damage. So this minus one here, if we would have rolled a six or a seven, anything like that, it would have taken one off of that to make it a little bit easier to hit. So those minus ones, minus twos, minus threes, adjust your dice roll on this die. In this case, you don't need it because this counts as a one, so you're good to go. So you got a Nuka-Cola bottle, which is good, which can prevent him from searching, because you see down here, anything within a blue, since he has that quick act, since he has that special action, he can prevent anybody within a blue of him from searching, which is just,
big radius.
Which is a pretty big radius, which is just the hound right now. So that doesn't affect too much, but it's still good in some scenarios. You have the star, which means Dogmeat gets another quick action, so he's got these. So he can search, or he can hunker down, or he can move if he would like. All right. And then you've got the two damage markers, which we went over, and the crit. So the crit is you're going to look over here. All right.
Yep.
And so you see your damage stays the same, but it allows you to roll another black die. So go ahead and roll another black die. All right, so that's a minus one. That didn't give you any bonus, so you're still fine. So you're looking at two damage from the first two that you rolled, plus these two right here. So that's four total damage. All right, so you've got four total damage going into this dog right here. All right, so I look over here at my mutant hound, and I look at his defense, and he only has one against your physical attack. So I can only stop one of those four if I roll a one. So I'm going to roll this one, and I'm going to roll a one. So I stop one of the damage. So three still come through.
And now he's mad.
And now he's mad.
So does he do his quick action now?
So Dogmeat can do his quick action now.
I think he'll search.
So
can he search?
He's not looking to search these for this mission. He doesn't want to search those. Because if he searches it and reveals it, then I know what it is. And I know
I don't want him to search.
Yeah, so you guys are trying to get your settlers and your guy to these terminals and trying to hack those terminals to open up this vault, basically. And I'm trying to keep you from doing that. So you can do a quick movement, so you can move with Dogmeat if you want to move him out of combat. You can do any of those things. So Dogmeat can't hack a terminal, but he can help defend it. Alright, so then now you still have this settler to activate here.
He'll use the baseball bat.
Alright, settler's gonna use the baseball bat. Alright, so look at the colored dice there on the baseball bat. You got a black and a yellow. Alright. And so since you didn't charge into combat, you don't get any bonuses because I charged into combat. So you're gonna find the corresponding. So you got the knife here, so find where the knife is on here. So strength three. Yep.
So three or lower.
So you're looking for a three or lower. Your settlers aren't too strong, but you have an option to make it. So you rolled a four, which doesn't get there, so that's a miss. You rolled a blank on the yellow, and it would have given you an extra damage here on the damage die. So that's a miss. But you get two actions per turn, so you get to roll again. Four again, and a blank. And this is an armor break, so that would have taken the one armor that he has, would have allowing all the damage to come through. But as you see, we missed again. So you're going to go ahead and flip this over, saying that he's done. All right, and then the turn would come back to me.
Okay.
All right. So I'm going to activate this super mutant here, and I'm going to move him up. He needs to get in the fight here. He's over here in the corner. He's not doing much. He needs to get in the fight. So he's got a bolt action pipe rifle. So he's gonna try to shoot some pipes downfield. So for the sake of this demo, I'm gonna do this just because I think it's a lot of fun and it's a really cool mechanic. So I'm gonna shoot into combat. You know, I really don't like that settler. He's holding my dog up. I don't like it. So I'm gonna try to take out this settler. So he's well within the short range here. So I'm going to find my short range here. So I get a yellow and a green on my short range here. So I'm going to need this accuracy here. It's going to help me out a lot, hopefully. So the way you shoot into combat is you have a 50-50 chance of shooting your own teammate. So you'll go odds and evens right here. So I'm going to roll this red dice first to see who I'm shooting. And thankfully, it's odds. which is a one. I saw that. Did the camera catch that? So I got lucky. So it's a 50-50 chance to shoot into combat when you're shooting into combat, which is I really like the mechanic. It's a lot of fun. You don't know, you know, shooting into combat, it should be a 50-50 chance, right?
At least.
So luckily, I'm gonna hit your survivor. All right, so I've got my green die, my yellow die, and my one white die here. And I'm gonna roll these off. Super mutants are horrible at shooting. So I'm looking for a 4 here because my perception is a 4. So I'm looking for a 4 or lower. Hopefully I can channel my opponent here and roll some 4s, which I did not. I got a -1, which takes it down to a 6. Still not enough. So those are his two movements. He tried to shoot, luckily missed the dog, still missed the settler, and he's just gonna stand there and be worthless. All right, so I will pass back to you because I've activated and moved my unit twice. So you've still got your sole survivor here and another settler.
We're all going with the sole survivor. So he'll move up here. How far can he go in?
Yep, so you're gonna look at the yellow, so you're gonna move.
Yeah, we'll do that.
Yep. Yep, so if you move, so you can move front to back, so that's going to put him far enough to where he can get to that terminal.
Okay. All right. So how's he activated?
All right, so you're going to look at the Soul Survivor, you're going to find the computer symbol on there, which is Intelligence 5. All right, so you're going to take that white die, and you're going to roll a 5 or less. And yeah. You roll the cog, which is good, which is an automatic pass, so he gets to hack that terminal. So that terminal is hacked.
And it gets
unlocked. He gets a quick action. So, since you have the dog handler, as you can see this, you
pass
can,
it off yep, here.
Yep, you can pass it off to Dogmeat because Dogmeat is close enough. So you can have Dogmeat do another move. So Dogmeat can move a red, or he can charge if he's close enough to somebody to a blue. So he can charge here.
Because he's got senses, doesn't need line of sight.
Yep, so he can charge here, or he can charge here. Which that one's going to be tough because you're going to have to go around. So you're going to have to go around to here and then come to here, which is still enough. So Dogmeat can either charge here or here.
But that guy will kill the dog.
He's pretty tough. He will have a pretty good chance of killing Dogmeat. So yeah, you can put Dogmeat over there. He charged in, and that's good. So because he charged in, you're going to give your little, you're going to put a little extra black attack here. So next round, come back around to dog meat. Okay. Yep. So next round, when you come back around to dog meat, because that was a quick action, you can't do anything after that. So that'll be your two motions here, because opening up something is a motion. So if you, it's an action. So if you hack a terminal, you know, break into a lockbox, any of those things are an action. They cost one action point. So I'm going to activate my last super mutant over here. Excuse me. And I'm going to start trying to move him up a little bit because he's not in a good spot. And he's just kind of out in the middle of nowhere. So I'm going to move him here. All right. And then I'm tired of this guy walking around here in all of his power armor and looking all pretty. So I'm going to go right after him. So I'm going to go right after him. So those are my two movements for him. I'm going to flip that one over. And I'm going to pass it back to you. So you've got your last settler over there to activate.
I guess I'll move up. And shoot.
All right.
So black and a green, and a red, right?
Yes.
And then a white die.
Yeah,
I've heard about
that. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm looking for 5. Las Vegas is happening.
I was on Twitter last night trying to read all the things. You didn't get it.
So those are a miss. Yeah, that takes you down to a 6. All right. So everybody's been activated. So you clear off all the tokens except for the except for your damage tokens there, except for the extra damage tokens. Alright, so those all get cleared up. Alright, perfect. Alright, so the way this works is if you went first last time, the opposite player goes first this time. If you don't have, if you haven't lost a model. So the team with the lowest amount of models always goes first. So if I would have lost a model, then I would have gotten to go first this time. But since we're both still even, the turn goes to you and it's your turn now. So you get to choose to activate first.
Go with the dog.
All right. So you can either use his two actions now, or you can pass to me.
I have a full-time job.
All right. So mutants aren't, the super mutants aren't too tough, but they can do some damage. So you're gonna look at the dog bite.
Yellow, green, and blue.
Yep. And always the white. Yep.
And the black because of the extra.
And the black because of the extra. So then you take that token away because you're rolling that extra because of the charge. So two is definitely a hit. All right, you've got the star, which on Dogmeat is an extra action. So you got that again. A blank, which is nothing, and a minus one, which takes that down to a one. So you're doing just fine. And did you roll? Yeah, so you're good. So you're good there. All right, so what's going to happen is I need to figure out if I can stop any of the two damage that are coming through. So I can only stop one. So I'm looking for a one. I roll the three, so all two damage come through. So I got two damage on my super mutant here on the left. And you can attack again.
Yeah.
But you don't get the black bonus this time. Yep, you got it. And you need to roll one yellow. Don't forget your yellow one. I don't think you rolled a yellow one last time. Go ahead and roll one. We'll see if it affects anything. Because the new Coca-Cola bottle stops his perception. Doesn't do too much there. But yep, there you go. Yep, you got the right ones. All right, so you rolled an eight. Which for Dogmeat is good enough because he attacks on his agility.
Which is eight.
And you got a negative two, which is good, which takes that down to a six. You got another star, so you can't get more than one quick action, so you can only do one.
All right, and you got armor.
But you ignore the armor, so I get no roll on that red die at all. So both of those damage come through this time. So that takes it up to four for my super mutant over here, which these super mutants only have six.
Okay.
So one more attack like that, and he's gone. So Dogmeat's used both of his. You can use the quick action if you'd like, or you can stay in combat and finish off that.
Use quick action and charge. That won't be effective until next turn.
It won't be effective until next turn.
Yeah. Do it.
All right. All right. And you get a black token.
Dog's all over the place. I like his dog.
He is. He's quick. He can move all over the place. That's his thing. But, as you can see, his agility and his health are the same. So as his health goes down, his ability to hit is significantly hindered.
Oh,
yeah. So, all right. So you went first. You activated. All right. So I am going to go ahead and activate my hound because he's not going to – I don't think he's going to last too much longer because he's already pretty wounded. He's only got two hit points left.
All right,
so he's going to try to do some damage while he can. So he gets the almost the exact same roll, except for he gets a black instead of a green. He's a super mutant, and so super mutants, because they're all strength 6 or above, get an extra black. All right, so they get an extra damage token. And because I'm doing the attack, I'll get to roll another black on top of that once we're done. So I'll roll this off. All right, see where we're at here. All right, so I got an eight, which is a miss, but I can still roll this black token. And if I get a minus one on it, I'm good, which I did not, so that is a miss. Very unfortunate. All right, so this black token goes away. That was my one attack on the charge, down to one black token. Actually, I still get to roll two, because one for his strength and one for his regular roll. So hopefully this is a hit. So this will be a hit. One damage, two more extra damage, a blank, and a star. So the star for my hound gives him an extra quick action, which is the same quick actions as Dogmeat. This is a blank, that's his quick action. That's three extra damage on top of the two that I'm already doing to your settler. So that's five damage going into your settler. So you're gonna take this. You're gonna look here, your settler only has four, all right? So you can stop one that's still doing four damage, so your settler is toasted. All right, so my hound is out of actions for the turn, except for he's gonna try to do a quick action here. And he is going to search and open this up, because that is a quick action he can do, and that's what I'm looking for right there, is that a little electrical box, so we can try to keep you guys from getting to that. But we're trying to get to that so we can smash it. So I'm going to try to get, so my next turn basically is I'm going to try to get my guys here, so I can get into base contact with that and smash it, so you can't open up any more of your terminals. So you're going to want to defend that for me at all costs. Because if I smash that, all the electricity goes down in your terminals, and you can't hack into that vault and get your little nuclear launcher there. A smart place to sit your strongest character.
Shoot, or he's closer. We'll shoot him.
Yep, so the way cover works in this game is that it's -2, period. Since he is in cover, that'll be -2 here. Even shooting over this fence, it's still -2. If I was this close to it and shooting at you, it's like you're shooting over the fence, you're using it as cover, so it doesn't affect you. It just affects when we're being shot at. So it will take 2 off of your perception, right, which is what you're shooting on. So you're looking at a 5, and you're gonna get, yep, you got the right colors in your hand, you're ready to shoot. So which one are you shooting at, this one or this one? This one? Alright. So you got the cogs. So you're rolling those cogs like crazy today. So -1 doesn't matter. You get the Nuka-Cola bottle on the hunting rifle, which doesn't do anything. Doesn't have any cool extras. But it is a hit. Alright, so I've got to try to take this red die here and try to stop one of those damage. Because I can roll a 1 and stop one. I'm going to do that. Nope, they both go through. So I'm going to take 2 damage.
I went there and it sold out.
So my guy on the right side takes 2 damage. All right, so those are both your moves for him, correct?
Yes.
Yep. So you get a cog action. So you can. So this is your him. All right. So you can either do something else with dog meat with him, or you can kind of hunker down and take a little more defense when I attack you next turn. All right. So we'll put one of these. I don't have all the tokens out here. We'll just put one of these right here for you to let us know that's what happened. All right. So it's back to my turn. So I'm going to activate my. I'm going to activate this guy. All right. And I'm going to activate him, and I'm going to pass to you.
He's gonna shoot.
All right. He's definitely within that close range. Still taking a -2 because you're shooting over that little fence there. My super mutant's gonna be really good at hiding behind that fence, that little picket fence. Yep, you got it. So you're looking for a 4.
No, I'm looking for. Oh yeah, I am.
Yep, so you got a 5, but you got a -2, which takes you down to a 3, so that's a hit, plus an extra damage. So we're looking at 3 damage coming into him, which is pretty significant. So I'm going to try to stop one of those, hopefully, and I don't, because my defense is only 1, the 2 doesn't do anything for me. So I'm taking 3 damage, which is not good, so that super mutant's down to 1 health.
Yeah, we're going to shoot him again.
So you got 7, which is way too high, an armor break, and an extra damage. So luckily for me, that one missed. All right, so back to me. I'm going to activate my brute here because I want him to do some damage. All right.
He trips on the fence.
I hope not. So I'm going to take this super mutant And I'm going to have him... I'm going to have him charge right in here. Alright? And then I'm going to have him do an attack. Since he is almost dead, might as well give it a shot, right? So he's got a board. Alright, so he's got one die from for the action die. He gets one black for the board. He gets another black for the charge, and I will roll one more black for him being a super mutant. So I am looking for a 6 or lower. I get a critical, which is fantastic. Nothing on that one. One extra damage there. My third black die is another extra damage. All right, so I'm looking at 4 damage coming your way, plus the crit, which is another yellow die. That's what I get for the critical, all right, which is minus 1, which doesn't help me at all, unfortunately. All right, so we've got 4 damage coming into him. So, interesting thing with the power armors. I'll show you how this works over here. So when you get items, they slide in just like this. So they line up with your special. Put that in front of the camera there so you can see. They line up and they show you what they add to your unit. Alright, so in your case, they're giving you 3 strength, 4 more endurance, and then it adjusts your armor. So the plus 1 in this case doesn't mean 4. So it doesn't mean 3 plus 1 equals 4. In this case, it means you have 3 base armor, and the plus 1 always negates 1 armor, period. Until you get 3 damage done to him, and then your power armor breaks, just like it does in the game. And then it flips over, and you have some different stats. But right now, you're going to immediately stop 1 of the damage I'm doing, and then you get to roll the damage die, and you're looking for a 3 or a less to see how much damage. And he's hunkered. So you're looking for 2 or less, because he's hunkered down. All right, so you rolled a 4, so the 2, so 3 of those damage come through. All right, so you are stopping the 1, and you got 3 more damage. So because I dealt 3 damage, your power armor is going to break. And that flips over, and that lines back up. You're still getting the extra strength, and you're still getting the radiation defense, but your plus 1 goes away. All right, so that's my attack from my brute there. And since he charged and only did and he did one attack, so he's done. So he is cashed out. So then it would be my super brute's turn here. Alright, so he's gonna try to get in the fun too. So he probably can't charge. He might be able to charge there, but I don't know if I want to charge there. I don't know if I, because I need to get him off of there. But I got this guy coming up from the side. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to take out this settler. So I'm going to take the brute here. And I'm going to bring the brute up here to face contact with this guy. All right. So as you saw last time, he gets the extra 1 for the charge. He takes this one right here because he's a brute. He's using the sledgehammer, so he gets 2 yellows for that. He gets 1 for being a super mutant and 1 black because he just charged. Alright, so let's see what he can do with that big old sledgehammer. And he is looking for an 8 or less. He rolled a 10, which is not good. That is a straight miss. So he whiffed big time.
Saw him coming.
Yep, saw him coming, big old whiff.
So clear.
So that is done with him. So I actually have 1 more left to go.
Oh, I'm a cheater.
Yep. Camera caught that. So I've got 1 more guy left to go, and that's going to be this guy. So I'm going to bring him in to a charge as well, to try to double charge on this guy over here, which is really good because on the double charge, you get a little bonus, all right? You get an extra damage roll because you're overwhelming odds on your opponent, all right? So... going to go ahead and cash that out. So he made his charge. So he rolls this. He's got a board. So he's getting 1 black. He gets another black because he's a super mutant and they're awesome. And then he's going to get to roll 1 more black after these 2 rolls are done. So he gets the cog and an X, which is a miss. So I don't really need to roll the extra one, but he gets an extra quick action, which I don't really want to use any of his quick actions, because super mutants aren't very smart. They don't have very good quick actions. They can't really do anything fun. So that's going to be the end of his turn. So we're going to go ahead and clear it. And his hunker down gets cleared out as well. That's only for the for momentary time. All right, now, since we're at the start of this new turn, and you have one less model than I do.
I'm first.
You go first.
We're going there.
All right. So, your sole survivor doesn't have a close combat weapon, so you have options. You can shoot into combat at -2 of what you're shooting into. So if you're using your perception, you're looking for a 5, which isn't bad. Or you could use where your fist is here at charisma, which is a 5. And you can charge in there. And you can use that, but it only has the opportunity to do 1 damage. So it's going to be a lot smarter to use that hunting rifle.
Yeah, we're going to shoot.
All right, so go ahead and... So you're going to get this. And you're going to get 2 yellow for that hunting rifle, because those are your armor breaks. And that hunting rifle is high power at close range. So that's good. That's a hit. -1. It doesn't really matter. So I have to try to block one of those. Are you shooting this guy or this guy? That guy? All right. So he's got 1 armor. He doesn't stop any of it. 2 go through, and that super mutant is cashed out. He is gone.
He got a... What's he get for the cop?
He has another quick action. So that's So he can pass that along to Dogmeat, who's right behind him, or he can hunker down, which he'll probably want to hunker down again.
Okay. And we'll shoot that guy.
Yep. All right, so you got an 8, -2, which is...
Not enough, I think.
It's not enough, you're 1 off, because you needed a 5, and you got a 6. All right, so that's a miss. All right, so that is your sole survivor's turn. He is gone. All right, so I am going to activate my hound over here and have him turn around and get angry at Dogmeat there, because Dogmeat's been biting at his ankles the whole time. So, I'm going to have him roll this. Roll a black, a yellow, a blue, and he gets the extra black for being a super mutant because they're awesome. All right, so we got a critical there on the dog. -1 doesn't matter. Breaks his armor, an extra damage, and a Nuka-Cola bottle and a star. So I can stop his perception, which is fantastic. He can't open anything or look at anything or find anything this turn. All right. The star gives him an extra quick action, which I might be able to move him out of combat here if I get rid of Dogmeat, which I can do 8 damage to him this turn. So I'm doing 3 damage. I get to roll another yellow, which is another armor break, which breaks both of Dogmeat's armor, so all 3 of those damage go through to Dogmeat. Not enough damage counters over here. Alright. Yeah, just 3. Alright, so he gets 1 more attack.
Fail.
And he rolls a 7. Which is too high, and I have no armor. I have no modifiers to bring it down, so I take all. So that's a big old miss.
Play a second lieutenant and a bunch of.
Back to you.
Well, we're going with him.
All right. So now remember, you have a -3 to that roll, so you're looking for a 5 on Dogmeat now because it's the same. Yep, you got that black die because of his charge. All right. All right, so you roll 3. -1 is 2. That's definitely a hit. An extra damage and 2 Nuka-Cola bottles. So that gives you 2. That gives you 2 of these, which you... I mean, you can stop me from opening stuff within a blue, but it's...
doesn't really matter.
Searching stuff, it doesn't really matter because you're standing on top of it, so you're keeping me from doing it anyway. All right, so that's a hit. Got the extra damage, so that's 3 damage. All right, my dog can only stop 1, he's got two health left, and so that's enough to take him out. So he is out of commission as well.
So he's still got another action.
Rawr. All right.
That's a charge, right?
So he is charging in. So go ahead and put that black token there.
Again.
Yep. Because he charged in, so he'll get that on his next attack.
I'm trying to think if anybody else might.
And then it will be to me.
To you.
All right.
Chris doesn't. Sam and John.
So since he's looking like he's going to be going down next, I'm going to go ahead and have him attack. And I'm going to have him attack. I'm going to have him attack Dogmeat. Because Dogmeat is really tough, and he's scary. So I'm going to have him attack Dogmeat. So I'm going to go with the board attack. I get one extra damage for being a super mutant, because they're awesome. We're going to roll this off here, and I miss. It's an X and a cop. So none of my super mutants don't have great quick actions, so nothing really special I can do there. We're going to roll off again, an 8. Way too much. Not going to happen. Looking for a 6. Two misses in a row, and the turn comes back to you. So now you have your soul survivor and one settler remaining.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we need another
settler here. No, he went.
Oh, that's right. He went, so Dogmeat went. So you have just your settler left.
Well, no, Gemini does this. So, like, next year it moves up even further.
Why not? Baseball bat.
All right. See what you can do with that baseball bat. All right, so you're rolling 8, so I believe that's a little too high.
Yeah.
So you got one more roll. See what you can do.
Crit.
So crit. That's exactly what you wanted to see. All right, so crit with a baseball bat. Yep. So it lets you do one extra damage.
All right.
Because you're going from 1 to 2, and it lets you roll that blue die, and then any of those symbols at the bottom help out a lot. All right. So my guy is now confused. All right. So I have to roll on my intelligence, and I have to roll a 3 or a less next turn, or I cannot make an attack, which is good for you. Really good for you. All right, so you had how many damage going through? 2 damage going through. I have 2 armor, so a 2 or a 1 stops some damage. Rolled a 3, 2 damage come through on my brute. Alright, so that was a pretty good attack from that little settler there. So let's see if my brute can do something good here. Alright, so he rolled that, which counts as a 1. This counts as a 1, this counts as a 1, which makes him automatic passes. So he is no longer confused. He's going to have some fun here going after your little settler there. So he's going to roll his sledgehammer with 2 yellows. And 1 black because he's a super brute.
It's somewhere in this direction.
Alright, so a 3 is definitely a hit. Gonna break your armor, which you only have 1. So that is 2 damage going straight through. Can't be stopped. So we're gonna do that again for his second action.
And it's a crit.
And it's a crit with 2 extra damage. And that is gonna kill him immediately.
Kill him like that.
All right. And then the brute is going to just rotate himself and start staring down that soul survivor. So then that would be everybody that's been activated. So you can pull all these off. All right. And now we both have 2 left on the board. So since you went first last time, then it goes back to me. You went first last time, and we both have the equal amount. So, since I'm going first this time, I will clearly charge my super brute in.
Yes.
And see if I can do some pain here. Alright, so he clearly gets in there, makes contact, and he is going to do some damage. So he's going to go here. It's 2 yellow, 1 black for being a super mutant, 1 black for charging in, and then he will get an extra black. Because, nope, he's not overpowered because there's 4 people there in close combat. So he doesn't get the extra one from that. So he gets a crit. He breaks 1. not two, but three armor, completely penetrating the Soul Survivor's armor, and a negative one, which unfortunately doesn't matter. So, he's going to be doing three damage. He's going to be rolling to see if he can do something else to your Soul Survivor, which he does not. And so he's doing three damage that goes straight through your Soul Survivor.
He's almost dead.
Alright, that is fantastic. Alright, so those are the Brute's two moves. It is on to you, sir.
Well, I think we'll activate him. No, we're going to activate the dog.
You want to activate dog meat? A double armor break that is two stars, which are two extra moves, a blank, and a extra damage. So I'm assuming you're going into this guy.
Yes.
All right. So he only has two life left. You're doing three damage. I can only stop one. So that takes care of this brute right here. That knocks him out of the game. So you still have one movement left and two quick actions.
So the quick action I can charge, right?
So the quick action, so you can charge. Yeah, so there wouldn't be much extra, you can't really get anything out of the other quick actions because of where we are in the game.
Right, but now I get to use the second action and attack.
Correct. So 10 is
way too high.
And that would be a miss. All right. So
But now,
since I don't have anybody else to activate, you get to activate your Soul Survivor and try to shoot me in combat. So you're looking at a 5+.
Right.
And you most definitely make that. So.
Wow, that was a brutal shot.
Yeah.
So it must be between the eyes.
Right between the eyes. So you're breaking all my armor. There's nothing I can do to stop that. And you're sending four straight through. Four, right? So that takes me to 6. And I've got two. He's got two health left. So that is a miss. Got the X and the cog, so that's a miss. So you have an extra quick action, but in this moment, there's not really much
to do with it.
Not really much to do with it. So that ends the round. So we'll go back, and since I have the smallest amount of models, I get to go first. Brute's gonna go and see what he can do. He gets the extra black because he's a super brute. Alright, he rolled a 7, which is under the 8, which is what he needs. 2 extra damage, which takes the board up to 4 damage, and he's breaking 2 of your 3 armor. So you can still stop. How many health do you have left?
2. 1.
So you had 1 health left. You can stop 1. I'm sending 4 in, so that takes care of him.
Yep.
So, with my brute, I'm going to have him turn around and try to swing it at Dogmeat here. Alright, so that's a 7, which minus 1 is a 6, which is a hit, an extra damage, and an armor break. So he's got 3 damage going into Dogmeat there, and you can only stop one of them. And you stop none, so you got 3 damage going into Dogmeat. That takes him up to 6 damage. Okay, you just hit that 2 over, it's a 5 underneath it. There you go. Takes him up to 6 damage, so he is down to agility 2.
There we go. Might have to for him.
Yep, yeah, he's flipped over. He's
come on, dog me. Go blue, green.
All right, so that's about the best thing that could have happened for you right there. So you rolled a, it is Fallout. So you rolled a crit with Dogmeat. You broke one armor. You got an extra damage, and you got a new cola bottle, which won't help you too much. But I only have 2 health left. You're coming at me with 3 damage. You broke one of my 2 armor, so you take out the brute.
And I would have still had to roll the extra.
And you still had the extra roll because of the
crit. Doesn't matter. So the dog wins.
So technically, it's a tie. Because Dogmeat can't hack terminals, and your goal was to hack terminals.
Go lick his face.
Get him up. So technically it's a tie, but we did end the game with getting out all the brutes.
That was good.
It's a lot of fun, man. It's a great game. You can line up against each other and do a whole book's worth of scenarios. There's a single player. There's 2 people can kind of go through a dungeon crawl together. There's a campaign where you can go through a campaign just like in the game, fight against mutants and stuff out in the wild, different bugs, as you can see on the card, a death claw, different things like that. Gather up items, get armor, get weapons. There's 72, 74 weapons already in the game, more stuff coming. And then you can set up and just play against each other like this. There's just a ton of options to play in the game.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Again.
Yeah.
See you guys next year.
We'll see ya.
Hi, guys. Meet the Nibbles, who's going to go down. She just decided not to go down my back, so we'll do this for her so she's comfy. Thanks for watching my video, and I appreciate it. Please hit the like button and share it if you know somebody who might be interested. And, of course, there's always Twitter and the Facebook thingy, and soon I have a newsletter coming. That'll be down there or in a link below, and my kitty cat loves that idea. There was one more thing. Oh, yeah. Subscribe. Be a part of my community, our community. Let's make it grow together. See you guys at a con somewhere or a local store, or if I'm driving through the country, maybe a game club. I don't know. You're not going to go knock down my camera. Bye, guys.